Hello student, this is Yasir Azam from Team LPS Sitapur. Okay, I am going to continue the chapter cell, of which 5 parts have already been uploaded. This will be the 6th part and very small topic we will cover. It is chromosomes. We are studying all the different cell organelles or the part of cells. So we are going to discuss chromosomes. What are chromosomes? They are basically thread-like structures which are usually present inside the nucleus. You can take the screenshot. This is a very short description. If you will understand this particular page, you will understand the entire chapter. And in nucleus they are present and they are visible only during the time of cell division. Okay, and what other thing we must know about chromosomes? They are genetic material, or they carry the genetic information. Genetic material is not a proper term, because chromosome ka jo strand hai, they are made up of DNAs, or each DNA contains gene which is responsible for carrying the characters from one generation to another generation. Means gene is a unit of heredity or inheritance. Okay, so this we will understand the composition. The chromosome is made up of DNA attached with histone protein. Single DNA is not called as chromosome. When DNA is wrapped around histone protein, we call it as chromosome. These are thread-like structure visible during the time of cell division. Okay. So the structure lies like, it is having a central part, we called it as centromere. This is a construction between two strands, here two arms of the chromosome. There are pair of arms present. These arms may be in equal size or in unequal size, means they may have the same strand size or different size. On the basis of that, we are having four type of chromosomes: metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric and telocentric. Okay. We'll be starting with metacentric. Metacentric, here we will discuss that it is having in between a centromere and the arms of the chromosome. Means these are called as chromatids. Okay, these chromatids are equal in size. Okay, metacentric, centromere is situated in the middle and both the chromatids are of equal size. In case of submetacentric, the centromere is shifted towards one side, a little bit shifted toward one side. Means one arm becomes little smaller than another. In acrocentric, the centromere is, comparative to submetacentric, it is shifted towards one side. Okay. And in telocentric, the centromere is nearly at the top. From the centromere, strand chromatids, just appear to be hung. So only one side chromatids are present because it is at the tip. These are four basic types of chromosomes. I think you must have understood what are chromosomes. These are thread-like structure present inside the nucleus, responsible for carrying the hereditary information. Nothing else is there in this topic. Four type of chromosomes you must have understood. Now the question comes, what do you mean by diploid and haploid number of chromosomes? Okay, diploid and haploid ko samajhne ke liye aapko ye pata hona chahiye ki we are made up of cells. Each cells contain the chromosomes. And these chromosomes are present in pairs. Okay, when it is alone, means not in pair, we say it is haploid. When they are present in pairs, they are diploid. Basically, germ cells ko chhod ke, means aapke jo sperm cell hai, ovum hai, ko chhod ke, in every cell they are diploid. Haploid means jaise hamare paas 23 pairs of chromosomes are present. Bahut se organism mein 2 se shuru hota hai, theek hai, aur ye hundreds of numbers mein jata hai, pairs mein chromosomes. ठीक है, सो डिफिनेशन प्रॉपर इसकी है, अ सेल विच हैज फुल नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम दैट इज टू ऑफ ईच काइंड इज कॉल्ड डिप्लॉयड. ओके, सो इन ह्यूमन बीइंग्स वी आर हैविंग डिप्लॉयड क्रोमोसोम्स, वी आर डिप्लॉयड सेल्स, वी आर हैविंग डिप्लॉयड नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स. बट एट द टाइम ऑफ सेल डिवीजन इन जर्म सेल्स वी गेट ओनली 23 क्रोमोसोम्स इन ईच सेल. अदरवाइज 23 पेयर्स आर देयर, पेयर्स मींस दे बिकम 46, बट when it is haploid it is only 23. So 46 is a diploid condition and this is haploid condition. Haploid hoga tabhi to from parent it will, mother parent, from mother it will come 23, from father it will come 23, become 46, then zygote will be a diploid cell. Baat samajh aa rahi? Haploid haploid milke hi diploid banega. Agar aisa ho jaye ki 46 mother se aate hain chromosomes aur 46 father se aate hain, it will become 92. So geometry disturb ho jayegi. So to maintain the geometry, haploid cells unite and they form diploid cell. So a set of understand from the board and just listen my voice. A set of comprising unpaired chromosomes of each kind is said to be haploid, and a cell which has half number of chromosomes, that is one of each kind, is called haploid cell. The gamete in human being is haploid. Okay, this was all about the chromosomes. In upcoming video, we will be discussing about the cytoplasm. Till now, we have discussed about the cell wall in broad sense, nucleus, chromosome. Upcoming video will be about regarding the cytoplasm. Keep studying. Be vigilant. Thank you, everyone.